song that we're going to be singing together as a group again today. The song service is going to be number 121. You may notice I wasn't looking at our last song. The words in the hymnal are different than the words on the screen for some of the verses. So just if you notice that when you're looking at your hymnal, that's why maybe everyone around you is seeing something different, and you might be seeing one verse. I noticed that. So I'm going to only go on the choruses because I only have a hymnal in front of me. And so if all is fair, just follow the screen in front of you for the words. Go tell it on the mountain. Hymn number 121. The next song you have, Harry, that I sent you? Yes, that is correct. 144. Oh, sing a song of Bethlehem. This is not a common one that we sing on Christmas, but if you've ever heard of the song, I Heard the Voice of Jesus Say. It's the same tune, just with different lyrics, more geared towards the Christmas thing.
Thank you.
Our next song should be Infant, Holy Infant, Lowly, hymn number 127. 127, Infant, Holy Infant, Lowly. Today is What Child Is This, hymn number 141. 141, What Child Is This. Thank you. Thank you very much for joining with us today.
Probably in this part of the segment of worship service, I like to say that probably one of the greatest verses that comes to mind on the theme of giving is the one in 2 Corinthians 9:7. See if you would agree how often this may be used. 2 Corinthians 9:7. Each one must give as he has decided or purposed himself. Not reluctantly, or under compulsion, other versions say grudgingly, for God loveth a cheerful giver. Now, God loves something here. And it makes allusion to another text that we came across this morning with Lolita. Proverbs 22:9. He that has a bountiful eye shall be blessed, for he giveth of his bread to the poor. God loves such joy motivated giving to others. Why? Because when you do that, it expresses contentment of something. And may I suggest that no love-motivated giving can ever be done without it expressing a contentment in God's gracious giving. Where truth comes from, to the believers. And so in this season, may we recognize that every good work, every blessing that we have received is only from Him. And that just like when the verse that started in 2 Corinthians, that this is a reason that a gift is closing the loop as to why this cheerfulness can be there, because after you, for the exceeding grace of God in you, he's praying. And he finishes that chapter, thanks be unto God for his unspeakable gift. Lord, we thank you for that gift of grace and the work that you through your Spirit, those in our lives. And may it be a genuine, true expression that there is a love-motivating reason as to why we give today. May that experience strengthen you and be real. Carry us on in this worship service with this Father. Thank you.
first I'd come up with a plan, but then I would come to angels yet. And when he talks in the story about when he told the angels how the angels cried, how they sobbed to think that they were going to lose Jesus from heaven. And it just broke my heart. I'm sitting there reading that, and I never really thought of that. Can you imagine? There's this multitude of angels just sobbing in sorrow because Jesus had to go down to the earth again. And I was just like, wow, really, it just spoke to my heart. And the verses I'm going to read now, give us the context of that. Luke chapter 2, verse 8 through 14. And there were in the same country shepherds abiding in the field, keeping watch over their flock by night. And lo, the angel of the Lord came upon them, and the glory of the Lord shone round about them, and they were sore afraid. And the angel said unto them, Fear not, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which shall be to all people. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, which is Christ the Lord. And this shall be a sign unto you. You shall find the babe wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger. And suddenly there was with the angels multitude of the heavenly host praising God and saying, Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill toward men. And can you just imagine the contrast there? How happy, how they were just praising God for what Jesus had come to do. And I was just thinking of that as I was reading that this morning. I just thought of the contrast. And that's how it can be for us. You know, sometimes we are in such sorrow about whatever's going on in our lives. But here, again, when we see God's blessing and work toward us, the joy. So, just wanted to read that with you. Thank you. Communion, those that are able, so that you can have prayer. Father God, we come to you this morning, a body of your people here. I believe grateful and thankful to you for your immense love. We cannot fully
Savior. Oh, notice those words. I hope you underline. I hope you underline.
what the Old Testament is. Malachi. Go before Malachi, there's Zechariah. Go before Zechariah, there's Haggai. And before Haggai is Zephaniah. All right, and there's the fourth book, going backwards. All right? Okay. And Zephaniah, chapter 3, verse 17. Yes, for the Lord your God in your midst, the mighty one, will save. Yes, God save you. It says, he will rejoice over you with gladness. He will quiet you with his love. He will rejoice over you with singing. Yeah, that's where the angels got it from. Yeah, they heard God singing. Yeah, the angels were singing. They couldn't help but sing. Yeah, they're still singing today. I believe God is still singing today. You know, I read a story written by Barbara Leninger, and she writes about the time that her and her sister, maybe this is the year 1755, they were living in the state of Pennsylvania, all right? And they were living there, and some